The project command in Sketch mode is an essential tool to create sketch entities of existing geometry. However, it has its own limitations. There are four other commands that are grouped together with the project command under project include. Let's take a look at how they can complement the project command. In this example, I have started a sketch on a plane that bisects this cylinder. I need to snap a line to the side of the cylinder. Without any projected entity, you can see that there is nothing for the line to snap to. Let's start the project command. Judging from the preview, selecting the cylindrical face, the top face, or the edge does not give us a projected line that we need. Let's try the body option. This definitely gives us what we need, but also results in a lot of unnecessary lines. This is where the intersect command comes in. It creates entities that are a result of the intersection between any existing model geometry and a sketch plane. By starting the command and selecting the cylindrical face, this gives us the entity that we need. Imagine the sketch plane cutting across the cylindrical face. This would be the resultant line. So this is a lot more intuitive. Let's repeat this same example, but with a sketch plane that does not bisect the cylinder. In this case, the sketch plane is offset from the center of the cylinder. The project command would totally fail in this case, even with the body option checked. Pay close attention to the preview in red while we look at this from the front plane. It actually projects the full extent of the cylinder no matter where the sketch plane is situated. Imagine shining a torch on a cylinder in a direction normal to the sketch plane. The projected line is like the shadow of the cylinder. It is always created to the full extent of the cylinder. Only the intersect command will be able to capture the sketch line that we need. This is another example to show that the project command might not be appropriate in certain situations. We need to create a profile between these two curves for lofting. The profile will be done on this sketch plane. We need anchor points on these two curves for the ends of the profile to grab onto. If we use a project command, the resultant entity created is simply a projection of the entire curve when looking normal to the sketch plane. It does not actually create any points to work with. When we start the intersect command and select the two curves, we can create points where the sketch plane intersects with the curves. So the intersect command is a great complement to the project command. It makes sense that they are grouped together in this case. The next three commands allow you to produce 3D sketches without actually having to perform a 3D sketch in space. Let's skip include 3D geometry for the moment and talk about the project to surface command. We have a curved surface here, and we need to create a path like so. This path follows the curvature of the surface. Looking from the top, it traces the path of an arc. We can sketch how the line looks from the top plane and project this onto the surface. I have prepared the top sketch beforehand. We can begin a sketch on any plane since the resultant curve will be a 3D curve. Go to Create, Project Include, Project to Surface. For faces, select the surface. For curves, click on the select box and select the arc. For project type, choose along vector. We are projecting straight down along the y-axis, so select that as a project direction. The resultant curve follows the surface and also the top sketch. This path can be used to perform a variety of functions. for example as a path for a sweep or as a path for a pattern on path feature. Let's look at the intersection curve command. In essence, this is a more advanced version of the project to surface command. It is commonly used for projecting two sketches onto one another. In fact, let's repeat the previous example using the intersection curve command. Instead of using the surface body, we shall hide it and unhide the sketch that was used to create a surface extrude. Again, start a sketch on any plane. Begin the intersection curve command and simply select the two curves. The resultant projected line is the same line as in the previous example using the project to surface command. The intersection curve command is especially useful for creating 3D curves of edges of very organic shapes such as a mouse. To attempt to create such an edge by performing a spline in space and dragging on the points along different planes can be very challenging. It is usually much easier to make two sketches to trace out how the curve looks from two different planes and then project them onto one another. Let's take a look at the include 3D geometry command. Frankly speaking, it is kind of a niche command. It allows you to project entities in 3D space. Since it produces a 3D sketch, again, it does not matter which plane you choose to begin a sketch. Let's start a sketch and begin a command. At this point, there is no dialog box. There is also no indication that a command has been started, except for the fact that when you leave the cursor stationary, you see a prompt to select objects to include. If we begin to click on the edges of the cube, you can see the projected entities in purple. The entities are projected in the exact same spot as the original entities, regardless of the sketch plane that you started with. You can also choose points or faces. This command can be useful for building composite curves by borrowing entities from different bodies and creating new sketch lines to join them, creating a framework of sorts. Since this command is in a class of its own, it is delineated from the other commands. So I hope that this summary has helped in some way to demystify the different commands under Project Include. The next time that you use Fusion, before defaulting to the project command every single time, do spend some time to think about whether other commands will serve you better.